Hi, in this Grasshopper tutorial we will learn how to create this geometry here. We can easily turn it into this. We can control this part here. We can make it narrow or thick. We can also control the overall size of this object. So, let's start from scratch. Okay, so first we start by adding a polygon. I will create a XZ plane. Give it a radius. Now I like to have this tip in this place here, so I will rotate this polygon. Degrees, and for the plane I will use this plane, 30 degrees, now I will explode this polygon. I only need these three segments here to get their index. I will bring a list item. A slider between 0 and 5 to check their indices. So this is 0. 4 and so it's 0, 4 and 5. I will bring a panel. For Grasshopper to read this as a multiple data entry, not as a paragraph, right click and choose multi-line data. I need to place a circle at the middle of each of these segments. So I will bring this element here, curve middle. Bring a circle. Now these circles are pointing up. So I will bring an XZ plane. And on these planes I will place the circles. Give them a radius. First, I will join these three segments here. Now I will revolve this curve. Now for the axis, I will create, I can do it in multiple ways, but I will choose an SDL line. The start point will be at 0, so type 0. Now the length doesn't matter, any length will do. And I will use that as the axis of revolution. Now, this is a full revolution. I only need the half. So here the domain is 0 to 2 pi. So I will use a panel and type 0 to pi. I will use the same revolution for the circles. Okay, so now I can subtract, do a Boolean difference between those two. From here, solid difference. I will bring a custom preview. Now I need to mirror this. For the axis, I will use the XZ plane. Now for the preview color, I'm gonna bring this create material component. This is more flexible when it comes to preview colors because it gives me control over the shininess and other properties. And I will bring a preview, custom preview. I will do the same for this geometry here. Give a value for shininess. I will use the same value. Now the reason why you see this difference in shininess is because the faces of this mirrored part is flipped. The faces are flipped. So I will flip those using flip polysurface. The last step is to rotate this part here. Degrees. The plane is the XZ plane. And 60 degrees. Now I have this version here. I can use the same color if I want. Now I can go back here and change the overall size. I can change the radius of these circles. And basically that's it for this tutorial. Hope you like it. If you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next video. Thank you.